fucking kidding me? That soundtrack is amazing. You got the touch. You got the power.
Ah.
How do you?
I was gay the whole time.
That's the next.
No, there's no way it was. There's no way a panda fighting Kung Fu for a third time was any better than the first time.
If you want more Rugrats talk and more talking about people's sisters that you don't know, you guys hit that subscribe. I'll let your boy.
Welcome. Yeah, shut the fuck up. We're starting.
Okay.
Every time with this shit.
You just interrupted me.
Welcome to the Bracket 6.
That's the beginning. Shut the fuck up. Shut up.
Go back to China, bitch. Shut up.
Shut up.
Is that right?
Shut up.
Dude.
Are you guys singing that Linkin Park song?
Dude.
What?
Is that classic rock?
Bro, tell me.
This is the beginning of the... Just...
Welcome to episode 6, bracket-wise.
Shut up.
Shut up.
One step closer.
Shut up.
Go back to China, bitch.
I don't...
Donnie Darko.
I'm not in on this joke. Oh, I saw that movie once. With a giant bunny rabbit.
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
Frank is his
okay,
name.
Okay, cool.
Oh, he has a name? He was credited? Awesome.
Yeah.
Good for him.
All right, let's do this.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's right. Maggie Gyllenhaal played it.
Yeah, he really likes cinema.
No, it was...
No, it's a joke because she's ugly.
Maggie Gyllenhaal?
Yeah.
She's not ugly?
Under what standards do you live your life?
She's not like a, how fucking not like the hottest girl
Maggie
ever.
Maggie Gyllenhaal? I don't know. Her being replaced with Katie Holmes.
I'm just
like
saying...
Kind of
look-wise.
Way better actress.
What I'm saying is, you wouldn't say no.
To Maggie Gyllenhaal? Yeah, probably.
But he's now he's just saying just bangs
well, no.
Ugly girls.
Okay, hang on a second.
Right.
Hang on a second.
He's like,
do
she
I know,
is ugly, I would not say no.
Do I know she's Maggie Gyllenhaal? Or
yes.
Is she just like a girl that I was
unless
like,
you're fucking because
if she's just a girl
even
that
if
was
it
like,
was just a girl who looked identical to
of
Maggie Gyllenhaal, or Maggie Gyllenhaal actress did not exist, you'd still bang her.
So the situation is a girl walks up and says, you want to bang. I think most guys would take pretty much almost anything.
No, I have fucking standards.
But, like,
I
would
no,
go, like,
I would worry about that person's
suspicious.
Yeah,
but
so
I wouldn't
would I.
go, like, work
like,
for
like,
it.
Like,
where?
What do you want? What
no,
is
no,
your
no,
aim?
No.
Are you guys going to lure me somewhere and carry me?
Yeah.
This seems
you guys are
going to
steal my kidneys.
No, and nobody
like,
sees
you guys
it.
Are going to take me to a nightclub where it rains blood and you're going to get killed by vampires, like in
Blade.
Blade?
That is one of the coolest openings of all time.
Yeah.
Blood Rave.
Yeah. But no, nobody goes and looks for a chick that looks like Maggie Gyllenhaal and like actively tries
Dylan
to
Dylan has
her.
The bracket in front of him right here.
Quit.
This is the bracket. It says, great God, kill me at the top.
Right on.
Chop up.
Chop up.
Go back to China, bitch.
All right. This bracket.
Why don't you say
yeah,
that
we're,
one more
we're
times.
Doing a bracket. We haven't announced the bracket. We haven't said anything. Except for fucking just... flail on each other for the first 20 minutes.
Can you tell me to go back to China one more time, Brad?
It might go be back a bit to more China.
Bitch.
Bitch.
I just love how that kid says it because it's so like middle school child says cuss words.
Yeah.
Where like you put
bitch.
So much emphasis on it.
On bitch.
Yeah, to where now,
go back to
now,
China.
Now we just throw the curse words around
bitch.
As though they're normal like parts. Like,
yeah.
Like, man, this fucking guy over here. And now, like,
that's why I would always argue that bitch is a more... a derogatory term to call a woman than a cunt because you can have such an emphasis on the bitch and like
dude,
really drive it home.
You can have
cunt.
You can throw some
cunt.
English on
you
cunt,
can,
dude.
You can. But the way that
no.
I say bitch to
no cunt
whatever,
is like a brick
and,
wall.
Yeah,
bitch rolls off
well,
the tongue.
See,
man.
Cunt will stop a girl on a track because apparently it's just like in their minds they know what's the worst
is
thing to call them.
Hurt words,
but I think
hurtful
best
language.
Cuss words. Gay wad. Throw mine up there.
That's a really funny one. If somebody called me a gay wad in a serious argument, I'd be like,
oh, it'd be awesome. What? It would like end the argument. You'd be like, let's just hug it out.
Yeah, I'd be like,
it's all good. All
right.
You guys want to? You want to test it?
No. What?
Cunt or bitch.
His wife just walked.
Yeah,
in.
Go ahead.
Go to town.
She's your wife. You do it. I do it if my wife.
Oh no,
was
I'm here. I'm a smart man. I'm not dumb.
Well, she already heard the conversation. What's up, Tracy?
What's up?
See ya. I'm sure that. I'm sure you'll leave.
Get out of this because no one wants to get punched.
Yeah.
Yeah,
David does.
Oh man,
you can do it on camera.
Please do it on camera.
And I hope it like swells up and it lasts till next episode. That way, David comes in and just
go
swan eyes.
Okay.
Should we do this now?
Yeah, start us off.
What's the topic?
I don't know. The only thing I wrote down was songs. So
greatest classic. Greatest classic. Hide a body.
No. Bathtub, fill it with cement, dump it in a river.
I feel like ocean. After like five, we'd be struggling so hard to come up with ones. I wanted to do the songs.
You didn't win.
That's okay. That's true.
It's the worst defense for an argument, by the way.
What?
Because we haven't really done that since like the first time we said that.
There's a lot of songs there. Let's do the songs, and then...
I think it'd be fun.
I did write down a lot of songs.
There's a lot.
You've listened to music.
You've listened to KSHE. Greatest classic rock song, which is a wide
so do I.
Variety.
And I still came up with this
classic
list.
A band. Classic rock.
You have prepared.
So we're going to leave a billion great ones out.
Yeah, we are.
But it's all good, though.
Yeah, and some asshole's going to be like, you didn't say this in the first two picks. Go fuck yourself.
You didn't say Freebird.
Bohemian Rhapsody.
Yeah. Right. That's got to be on there for sure.
Really? I wouldn't even put that in my top queen song. Princes of the Universe.
No, but this is not...
This is not, classic, not David's favorite jerkin' music.
No, I'm saying, like... You can take it either. You can be like your favorite song, or you can be like the greatest. What would be considered the greatest?
That is Queen's big. Well, no, is We Are the Champions might be Queen's biggest song, which is weird because I don't really.
I glanced at a handful of lists, and the top Queen song was always Bohemian Rhapsody.
Was it?
Always.
I wonder how hard it or how high it shot. Because that's just another person's opinion. Like, what about how high they charted?
Well, I'm talking about this was.
I guess they could be all number one.
No, I'm saying like most of the time, Bohemian Rhapsody was in the top 5 or 10 all time, and it was And I'm not talking like some random guy wrote a blog and listed his songs. I'm talking about like music journals, Rolling Stone, like things like that.
That's still technically just one guy, though.
No, it's not. They sit around and like work those lists out. Not just one. It's not like, hey, you get to pick the top 50 songs of all time, Brad. Have fun.
Dude, from the way...
Fuck,
dude,
I wanted that job. Maybe you'll get it next year, Bill.
No, dude, from the way that some of those articles are, I wouldn't be surprised if one dude, because Mumford & Sons, no matter what category it is.
It's
Mumford
your turn to pick something.
I'm going to do The Chain by Fleetwood Mac.
That's a good one.
It's a great one. They could all be Fleetwood Mac songs. I'd be happy.
Fleetwood Mac is a great
with
band.
One Ario song.
You said what?
Fleetwood Mac, The Chain. The sweetest bass line. You should appreciate that, gentlemen.
I hate bass. It's the worst instrument.
It is. It's pretty useless. You don't have to do it in there to make someone feel self-important.
I'm going to start with one of my... I did more or less like my personal...
Yeah.
Enjoyment.
Yeah, no, me too.
Sure. Bad Company, Bad Company.
Yeah. Oh, that's Bad Company by Five Finger Death Punch.
No.
That's
not
a good
classic
cover,
rock
though.
Song.
No, it's
not. I think it's a decent cover.
I don't think any song that like is like a classical rock like should be covered by anyone, period. Like, fuck you.
The Atari's did a really good Boys of Summer song. Cover.
That's fine. Boys of Summer is like an in-between track.
Boys of Summer
Don
is
Summers
a, like,
or whatever
pop.
His name is or
it's
Don
like
Simmons
kind of
what's his
song.
Name he'd be yeah he would disagree he'd be like fuck
I'm
you
I'm going with there's tons of good ones but I'm gonna say the most iconic one is Van Halen Ain't Talking About Love.
Ooh, I almost did Van Halen Dreams.
Journey, Don't Stop Believing.
Hold on, dude, like I gotta like write like wait a lot of shit. What now?
Journey, Don't Stop Believing.
Yeah, that's like... That's that classic. Might be the one.
Don't Stop!
So, if we're talking about just popularity, it's that Stairway to Heaven.
Yeah.
Freebird.
Pick one.
I was going to do Wheel in the Sky, but I'm like, let's not do another Journey one. Let's do Spirit of the Radio by Rush.
That's I have that on there, dude. I love that opening.
Dude, that song has... Like the keyboard, the drums, the bass, the guitar, the melodies, everything.
All the instruments
awesome.
That the band uses? Yeah, I know. It's crazy.
Yeah, no, I'm just going to throw a top notch in that song.
This is the way you put it. He's like, dude, that Rush song, it has keyboard and drums
and guitars.
And bass. Like, yeah, don't all their songs have those things?
So many instruments.
So
see, personally, for Queen stuff, like obviously, I do love Masters of the Universe.
Yeah.
I literally opened up. I did.
Universe.
I literally opened up like almost every one of my Twitch shows, where I just would find a random awesome picture online of something I enjoyed, and then I would just play that entire song before I came on camera every episode.
Nice.
Was it ever a Duncan MacLeod picture?
Nope.
Oh man. Like SpongeBob, I have been shot.
I'm gonna go not Stairway to Heaven. I'm gonna go Black Dog.
Black Dog.
Zeppelin.
That's a yeah.
Good the guitar riff is too. Legendary.
Uh-huh. It has guitar, it has bass, it has drums.
It has drums, it has everything you need. There's not a lot of songs with all those in them. Like, you got a lot of shit. You know what I mean?
You're up.
I'm gonna
steal my shit again.
No, I'm gonna disagree with. I was gonna say AC/DC. I'm gonna say Back in Black.
Ew. That's another good one too.
Damn, with Thunderstruck. That intro guitar, even though it plays in the whole song,
yeah,
it's pretty legendary. I mean,
Back in Black. I started writing Thunderstruck.
Honestly, if we're gonna go up, Those About to Rock, they actually have cannons.
What
cannons? And for Those About to Rock.
Yeah, but it's not.
It's as a real. They brought a cannon into a studio. I'm just.
Not as like.
How mad would you be with the producer? Like, get this shit out of here.
Crazy train.
How do you mic up a cannon? You throw a blue mic inside the cannon, wherever it launches.
I gotta pair this
against something.
Crazy train.
Trying to figure out what the best to pair it against with.
Paranoid might be
one of my
favorite albums. I'm gonna go with a song that has guitar, bass, drums. And in the middle, they start chanting America.
Oh, hold Sticks. On. No, yeah, it's Sweet Mad or it's Sweet Mad
Sweet Madam Blue.
Yeah. That's a good one.
It's a good soft song, and then at the end randomly it's just busting this awesome like
Sweet Madam Blue.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a great song.
It's spelled all fucked up too, but yeah. I was like, it's just like all they chant. I might have taken Brad's last three picks. The America song.
I am going to pull from my list Carry On My Wayward Son.
It's good. Stand a looking glass. You're not a child anymore.
Thank you, Supernatural.
I can never. Because
whenever that song plays in Supernatural, you know shit's gonna
I can never imagine being a huge Sticks fan and waiting for the new album and then Mr. fucking Roboto comes out. You're like, no!
every season finale like before of the internet, Supernatural, you just push play and you just hear Carry On My Wayward Son kick in, and then it just shows like the most badass fight clips and scenes throughout the entire season.
They do a season recap?
Over almost the entire song of Carry On My Wayward Son.
That's pretty cool. Is it always the same song?
And the show, I know you don't know a whole lot about it, but the show is like a dad essentially trains his two sons to fight supernatural shit,
mm-hmm.
and then he fucking dies.
And then he tries to sell his shirt at the store, and it gets banned. It gets recalled.
Here. Your turn.
I'm gonna go with In the Air Tonight by Phil Collins.
Oh.
I know it's not like a classic rock song as much. It is, but it's
mine's
not.
Gonna be all the Tarzan songs by Phil Collins.
All the old Tarzan
songs. All the Tarzan songs. How many picks do we have left? Just one each?
Yeah, we each
have one personal choice. Golden Earrings, Twilight Zone.
That's a great
Ooh.
One.
Yeah.
We used to karaoke that all the time.
It's fun as fuck.
Oh man, there's two that.
It's 2 a.m.
I say there's two that need to be in here that I'm afraid aren't going to get picked.
He's gone.
Guns get still one. Warm.
I get one more. Should I go Dream On by Aerosmith or Here I Go Again by Whitesnake? One of the most simplistic songs, but still classic and timeless.
Probably Aerosmith.
Because Dream On's amazing, but God, Here I Go Again is so catchy.
Yeah.
And everyone loves that song. Or Magic Power.
I don't know, just pick one, you fuck.
You know what? Fuck it. I'm going with none of them.
Dream On.
I'm going to go Boston's Long Time / Foreplay.
That's a great one.
Or Foreplay / Long Time, right? Because Foreplay is the musical part in front of it, but it's only one song. The jam.
Foreplay /
Long Time. Foreplay Long Time.
I don't get the reference.
Oh, my final song. Damn.
Aerosmith. Living on an edge. Living on an edge. If you do Looks Like a Lady, though, that'd be hysterical. I didn't like the 90s version of Aerosmith. I felt like with Pink and Dude Looks Like a Lady and stuff, they got a little weird.
Dude, Aerosmith is hit or miss for me, man.
I don't want to. But I love all the old shit. Sweet Emotion, Living on the Edge.
You, baby, and I don't want to miss a thing.
Never mind. I take it all back. That song is incredible.
I'm doing
Bob
Seger, Turn the Page.
Turn the Page. Ooh, that's a cover that's actually better than the original.
No, it's not.
By Metallica?
And I can prove it.
You can't.
Statistically.
Bob Seger.
Get one? Yeah, you have
Bob Seger said Metallica should wrote this song.
Hmm? We didn't.
Shit, I got Metallica tickets. Ooh, you know what? Is Metallica classic rock? Because it's how Master of Puppets would win this whole thing.
No, Metallica's like a metal band.
Yeah, but they were in the same time, though. They wrote albums before we were born.
Yeah, they are classic. Yeah.
Yeah.
They're played on those stations.
All right, they're Master of Puppets. Contest
you don't have
Let's
a pick anymore.
Let's go home.
Smoke on the Water by Deep Purple.
Yeah.
Bam, 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 bam.
The first song, Dad and Brain Stew, are the first songs that they were kid learns to play on a guitar.
Yep, that's, yep.
All right, round one. Queen, Bohemian Rhapsody versus Boston, Four Play Long Time.
Mm. It's a hard one.
Queen.
Boston sounds good, dude.
The instruments are cooler in Boston. More technical.
But Queen, dude, that singing is so goddamn good.
That, and then, like, the style, too. Like, it's original. Like, here's the thing. Like, they came with a blank canvas, and they, like, did something that, like, changes, like, styles and song.
Yeah.
Like twice or three times. But then again, we don't have a really lame Panic at the Disco version song of a Boston song, so I'm picking Boston. I'm going to stay in Boston. Panic at the Disco covered
that
song for the Suicide Squad soundtrack. It was in the movie.
Oh, did they?
Yeah. It was one of the inconsistencies I saw.
I'm not going to judge Queen by
because
somebody
else
picked
back
on. I know.
I'll go with Queen.
I'm just making it topical for the audience.
Boston song is
they
awesome.
Can relate to Panic.
Well, that's the problem. Most of these songs are going to be really awesome.
Yeah.
They're all really awesome. But it's weird that we didn't have any Skynyrd or, like...
You know what? I didn't actually... I kind of figured that someone else would grab, like, Skynyrd and stuff like that. So, like, when I was going through, like, yeah, there's... Here's what happened. Here's why I love... Lynyrd Skynyrd's great.
Yeah.
But Tony played that shit so goddamn much that, like, I just... Like, I know it's great and it's fantastic... I don't need to hear it ever again, though, because
there's also
so
only
many
so
times.
Much of that classic rock that you
can same thing with Sammy. My parents, I played
rock.
Sammy for, like, they're, like, 50 for 50 years straight.
Sammy?
And, like, I love Sammy Hagar. He is, like, one of the best catalogs, like,
he's
especially right. If you combine his Van Halen stuff.
Yeah.
He has so many singles. They're all good, but I don't listen to him anymore.
Van Halen, Ain't Talking About Love,
yeah.
Versus Sweet Madam Blue.
Sweet Madam Blue.
I'm going Halen.
Because
yeah, I'm going Van Halen.
Because you did a Roth and not a Sammy. Not a Hagar.
Roth is always better.
Yeah.
Are you saying that because of your name?
No, I'm saying that because of Ice Cream
true.
Man.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm an Ice Cream Man.
I really do think, I know it's a hot take, but I think Sammy Hagar is a way better vocalist.
He is.
Than David Lee Roth. And they wrote
is.
Better songs.
David.
Just Van Halen just wrote party
songs. David's way off
course. Yeah,
he's
I'd say
he's like a cartoon.
He's a much better frontman.
They wrote
remember
awesome.
Chris Kattan
they wrote awesome party
the,
songs.
This the
both Hagar. They wrote
him,
songs like
yeah.
Songs, which wasn't very Van Halen.
Wearing the
not
sailor
Van Halen.
Hat.
Van Halen, like all Van Halen singles or Sammy have love in the title.
Yeah,
because Sammy's like, guys, let's quit down this partying, put down the beers.
Let's become lame and.
Listen.
Because, yeah, I mean, Dreams
I
and shit,
to,
they're all good songs,
choose,
but they're...
How many people from Van Halen have died?
Just take it from me. Just, I'm going
like,
to wrap
yeah,
this up.
Yeah, thanks, Sammy. No one gets to be a legend because of you, you pussy bitch.
I'm going
to
wrap this up right now. Van Halen has influenced my musical lack of their career.
Yeah.
Since I was a child. Van Halen is probably my favorite band. So just take it from me.
Yeah.
Just David Lee Roth is way better, but...
The song
no,
Human
no,
Beings.
Just,
okay,
no, shut your mouth. No, David, he laid down the groundwork
David.
Where it's inarguable.
David, what? Did you ever see Chris Kattan do his impersonation of David Lee Roth? It's fantastic.
Is it
wins.
Okay.
Me.
But Sammy Hagar is technically better. You're correct.
Yeah.
But he's not.
And my uncle is named David Lee Roth.
Is he?
Yeah.
Yes.
Dude.
He's not the
cool.
David Lee Roth.
His parents were like... The only one thing to do with the last name Roth.
Don't you think you've had enough cocaine?
Yeah, Dr. Roxo is based off of David Lee Roth.
Is he?
Yes.
He's been wearing the goddamn
so
hat.
So you lose, period.
Where's all my bananas and all my sandwiches? I'll fucking kill you!
Why didn't you guys lead with that?
AC/DC Back in Black versus Carry On My Wayward Son. This is a fucking heavy hitter, in my opinion.
No,
I'm going Carry On, just because personally right now it's more meaningful to me.
I'm going to go Carry On, too. Just carry because on. Of the breakdown? The
breakdown I'm the only in the middle, one. You guys all three agree. I was going to say AC/DC.
Dude, the breakdown in the middle where it goes, boom,
Dude, it's so.
It always reminds me of South Park that when Randy's trying to play it in real life and the kid's like, that's lame. We're going to play the
Guitar Hero. Up a sober cover higher.
Here's
like, Dad, you're lame.
Here's what I understand. Like, that structure, like the song, like, there's so many artists who are really talented today.
Except not.
But.
They got 18 trash can players, dude.
Songs, everything. It's guitar, trash cans,
guys that just headbang. I know they don't play it.
But like, song structure feels so cookie cutter nowadays.
Yeah.
Like, you listen to these, almost all these old songs. It's just like, I know, like, normally, like, a song is supposed to be like verse, chorus, bridge. Maybe a bridge instead of a verse, and then we'll do a chorus, and then we'll end on, like, a chorus thing out at the end. After, like, and it's like, it's just like, okay, next song.
70s and 80s
like,
was the coolest.
This shit, just guitar like, solos hey, randomly. Yeah. I got this really cool thing I've been working on. You can't really write the lyrics today to it.
And thought, maybe we switch it up a little bit.
like, it's just like, hey, I got this really cool riff, and there's no way you could sing over it. But then, like, in the middle of the song, can I just do it?
For a minute.
For, like, a minute and a half?
Like, what is it?
Fucking go for it, man. Do it.
Yeah, I Speedway and like,
we acapella sing like opera singers
about
the devil?
I feel like if all, like, modern vocalists are like Tom, like, in his bad days, that's why it's like that. That's why songs are like that now. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Like, it's like, because, like, we wrote that awesome shit, and he's like, he was having trouble singing over it, so he wanted to scrap the song. Yeah. No one knows who Tom is. It's just a one.
But he's Brown Miguel Dilvin.
Can't say his last name.
No.
All right.
Stilvin.
I have no problem with the guy. I have no. You know what I mean? Like,
it was just, I still don't like
in
him.
God, I was trying to keep this.
All right. Anyway.
Next one on the list: Tommy Rush, Spirit of the Realm.
Radio.
I know. I just wrote it really shitty and ran out of room.
They are. They are Lord of the Rings fans.
And Phil Collins in the Air Tonight.
Rush. I went against my own.
Phil Collins might be the only one on here that I wouldn't say even deserves to be on here. Rush.
Should have done Land of Confusion.
Yeah, but it's not as iconic, though.
I don't know.
You should have done any other
Disturbed
band
covered
that rocked.
It. Obviously, yeah. It's super obviously important.
That was a good cover, though.
Well,
it
you
is
think?
A good cover.
Oh, Rush. Of
Rush.
Collins
I'm
going to
go
be
Rush.
On here. Genesis.
I like his, like, super sarcastic, like,
what
obviously, it's awesome.
Collins.
Okay, yeah, I have you actually marked. Okay.
Yeah.
Spirit of the Realm.
Yeah. Every time he writes it, just write something different. Spirit of the.
Spirit of the hot dog.
Spirit of the roof.
Speaking of which, all right, something else get on here.
Ghost of the Realm.
Brad, bad company versus golden earrings.
I'm gonna go with golden earrings. Song's fun.
I
want to
point out how cool it is that a band name, that a band just did a song with the title of their band name.
It's the name of the CD, too.
Yeah, is it?
Bad Company.
Is it the only track on the album?
Listen, guys, this might be the only album we do. We got to make sure people know who the fuck we are.
We've already made the shirts.
Please name
the song Bad Company by Bad Company off their hit album Bad Company.
Right, guys, we made this t-shirt way before we named our band.
I don't know why
song
this made
name, and then, like, just name it everything. Everything's Bad Company.
Yeah.
I don't know why it's made me think of it. I was thinking like a game show. It's like, please name the following song. And then,
yeah.
It's like, Bad Company. Incorrect. That's the name of the band. But
no, the lead singer should have changed his name to Bad Company. Just to, like, just Bad Company Records, Bad Company.
Oh, in 30 Rock, I don't know why this made me think of that, but in 30 Rock, Alec Baldwin comes up with a game show called Homonym.
And
they just,
homicide.
Like, they just list like words that have multiple meanings, and then you have to guess the definition. And every time the host is sitting there and he'll just be like, say the word, and they'll be like, blah, blah, blah. He's like, no, it's the other one. he says it, he's like, no, it's the other one. He's like, let me see the cheat. He's like, no, you can't look at it. No, it's the other one.
If you got Steve Harvey to host that, I'd watch that show. Steve Harvey has sent us everything.
And it becomes like the most popular show in America because it's so fucking stupid.
If Brad would have said Radar Love.
Have you seen the Steve Harvey picture where he's like, in the Super
Bowl? Twilight Zone better than Radar Love.
It has to be Bad Company.
I'm going Bad Company.
The Super Bowl or the Steve Harvey picture where he's like, and the Super Bowl winners are the Atlanta Falcons.
Dude, that's so old.
It's
pretty old.
That was funny though.
But it was funny.
What is it?
Bad Company versus Golden Earrings.
Radar Love.
Golden Earring.
It is a tie then.
I'm just playing it. It's not Radar Love, Tommy.
Just.
I mean, Radar Love's good too.
Radar Love's great. Speaking of, it has bass in it.
I'll use my veto power for Golden Earring because I don't want to have to call anyone.
That's fine.
What? We get veto powers?
Apparently.
We did 1 week.
Oh.
And we never did it again.
I brought it back.
I was like,
I just don't want to have to wait to call somebody.
Fleetwood. Oh. The Chain.
Fleetwood.
Versus Crazy Train.
Fleetwood.
I'm going to go Crazy Train.
Going Crazy Train also.
The Train, you know, what happens at David's house.
You say the
Friday
Chain?
Night when we record.
You said the Chain, that's a tie.
Train.
The Chain or the Train?
The Train. You know, what happens at David's house when he's here.
You sound like Steamboat Willie. That is really fucking sweet. Randy Rhoads is my second favorite guitar player of all time.
That's Zach. I think it's Zach Wells.
Oh, that's not Randy Rhoads?
No, I think it's Zach. Isn't it Zach?
I didn't know that Zach Wilde was ever in.
I don't fucking know.
Wait,
like,
Zach Wilde has a band now called Zach Wilde Does, Black Sabbath. Well, he just plays Black Sabbath. I didn't know Zach Wilde was ever in Black Sabbath.
It might be Randy Rhoads. Yeah, it is Randy Rhoads.
Right. I thought so.
You're right.
I thought so, because I'm better than you.
Dude, Kirk Hammett's number one. Hands
Kirk,
down.
What?
Hammett.
The fuck did you just say?
Just do the next one before
Hammett
they kill
is
each
the
other.
Best guitar player?
Well, hang on. You've
under
listened
what?
To Metallica songs, right?
Okay, first off, let me explain something. David would literally drop to his knees and suck every dude's dick in
not
Metallica.
Lars, but yeah.
Because this dude is so obsessed with them, and if you try to say everyone that any band
Metallica.
Is better than Metallica,
well, no.
He will literally spend the rest of his life trying to prove
I think three
wrong.
Bands are better than Metallica. Kurt, I think Rush is better than Metallica.
But I play the instruments.
Yeah.
End of discussion. You're fucking wrong.
Well, that's not true. You don't play them very good. What's your band's name?
My band's name?
Exactly. So anyway.
What's your band's name?
I don't have one. But I'm not claiming to have one. But I'm not claiming that that's...
Tom,
Kirk Hammett is not better than Eddie Van Halen.
Yeah, he is. Eddie Van Halen sucks. He has no teeth. He's a meth mouth. Piece of shit. But yeah, no. I don't know.
There's no effect on his guitar playing at all.
No, because David's a fucking asshole.
No, Kirk Hammett just wrote...
Just next bracket.
Sorry.
Next.
And then Randy Rhoads a second.
Next!
Eddie Van Halen's like...
Next! Six.
Journey, don't Eddie, stop believing ew. Versus Smoke on the Water.
Eddie's like six.
I'm going Journey.
Because then you got Santana that's better than
Tommy.
Eddie.
Tommy.
Santana is not better than Eddie.
You're just racist.
Tommy. Journey.
Santana's good.
Don't stop really believing. Good. Stop engaging the Billy, fucking gremlin.
Billy Squire is better than... I'm just playing, he's not. But dude, Billy Squire is pretty good, though. About. Melissa Etheridge is better than Eddie Van Halen.
Second podcast. Don't Stop Believing or Smoking the Water. How many votes? Do we have one? Who voted already?
I did, Journey.
Don't Stop, Don't Stop Believing.
Don't Stop Believing.
Should have been Any Way You Want It, but Don't Stop Believing. Just saying.
I can't wait till the end of this so I can explain something.
Yeah. That's what I
do. We can disagree, but I just want you to know you're wrong.
It's cool. If it wasn't for
Tommy,
me...
Tommy, Led Zeppelin, Black Dog versus Bob Seger, Turn the Page.
Black Dog.
If it wasn't for me, this wouldn't be that much of a show that you guys would just be voting and that's it. I'm trying to make it a show and read dialogue up. What was it?
All your points are wrong.
Bob Seger, Rock and Roll Never Forgets or what? Oh, wait, you picked the wrong song. Led Zeppelin, Black Dog. Black Dog. It's cool. Being wrong is an epidemic at the /podcast. I'm here to fix it.
Take guitar advice from you who does not know what an acoustic can do, that you can just literally hit it again to make another noise.
Queen, Bohemian Rhapsody versus Carry On My Wayward Son.
Oh.
That's hard.
Vocals versus guitar.
Yeah, pretty much.
Bohemian Rhapsody.
I don't know. I think the guy from Kansas has a pretty hard voice. He had some pretty hard notes.
He's not
Freddie Mercury.
But it's not the Shining.
He doesn't have the mustache of Freddie Mercury.
I mean, it doesn't. I mean, because there's like harmonies and shit in Bohemian Rhapsody.
He doesn't know what a harmony is.
Yeah. I'm trying to think, is that what the bass? No, Kansas.
They're like acapella part of that shit.
I'm going Carry On.
Acapella means all instruments, no vocals, right? Man. I love you guys.
Just that middle part, bro.
This is hard.
I'm going to set David on fire.
I don't want to set the world on fire.
Should have been.
I'm gonna go.
Should have been Forget About Dream. But.
Queen.
That is a tie.
Do I just have veto powers now?
If anyone can use it.
Oh,
I'm using mine for.
I can't decide though.
I'm using mine for the last round where I'm gonna veto Dream On.
Can't veto the final round.
I'll veto Kansas.
He's like, I veto Spice Girls.
Didn't
in there.
You vote for Kansas?
Yeah. No, I mean, I'll veto for Kansas to win. I'm using my veto power for the power of Kansas. Not the state, though. Hate all those fucking...
Not upgrades. The state, though.
Yeah, I said it a long time ago. You build a super, like, 800-lane highway to cover the entirety of the state. You put solar panels on the...
You put
the whole... No.
Over
parking lots. We elevate it. We elevate it. You put solar panels underneath, and you let them grow the fucking corn that we need to get from that shithole. That's it.
What? The highway?
Highway.
Nobody wants corn. Can we grow it any better?
Everyone in Kansas just lives under a bridge. It grows corn for us.
So nothing has changed from what they do now.
Right. It's just the rest of us don't have to deal with
we
it.
We don't have to see them.
They live under bridges now. They're troll monsters. No. I'm just kidding.
I like the fact you just pay
for
everything.
Fuck you. Remember all the jokes we drove through? We're like, yeah, dude, cops literally pull you over. Like, you know how fast you were going? Yeah, 60. Yeah, this is fucking Kansas. Don't you want to get the fuck out of here? Do like 80, bro. It's fine. We understand.
My roommate in Huachuca, he was from Kansas, and he put a flag, the Kansas flag on his side of the
wall.
They
have a flag? We allow that?
It literally looks like something somebody made in their art class. It's terrible. It, like, an elementary school art class.
Did it have, like, clip art from, PowerPoint?
It's blown up. Because I explained it to him, because he was like, look at that flag. Yours is stupid. It's just got a bear. We got a bear and all this other shit. I'm like, yeah, but, like...
Bears are cool.
Kansas is flat, so this is like you're in Kansas.
You're
looking
lying.
At all of the
look
good
at those hills.
Shit.
Those don't exist in
yeah,
Kansas.
Yeah, you're looking into Missouri. You're looking at all the good shit into Missouri. Is what I told
this,
him.
This is and the border of
pissed.
Colorado.
Are you talking?
Yeah, now he lives in Missouri, so it's funny.
It's
funny.
Just like how the Grinch stares down at Whoville and he's just
yeah, but
pissed
actually
out
the joke's on us because the people from other states are listening to us. Like, who, they're both fucking shitty.
Yeah, dude, Missouri, like, Ferguson, are you just kidding
yeah,
me?
Like, which? Like, yeah, you guys. Oh, good job, Missouri.
Look, we annexed that part of Missouri. Ferguson doesn't exist
I mean,
in Missouri.
It belongs to Illinois now, where it belongs. It, all the other shittiness.
It does try to. We tried. I mean, like, they tried to burn it off the face of the map, but it didn't work.
David.
What's up?
Van Halen Ain't Talking About Love versus Rush Spirit of the Con.
Oh, Rush.
Spirit of the Con.
Wait, I missed that. What'd you say? I can't understand him. There's laughter.
Spirit of the Cunt.
Yeah.
Spirit of the Cunt.
The Cunt.
That's what we should do from now on is just replace words with cunt randomly cunt. In our podcast.
Spirit of the Cunt, one vote.
Cunt
Spirit
black.
Of the Cunt, two votes.
What?
Halen Ain't Talking About Love versus Rush Spirit
Van Halen
of the
Ain't
cunt.
Talking About Cunt.
He ain't talking about cunt. How many votes for either?
It's two for Rush right now.
We'll go Van Halen.
Halen.
Tie.
Yeah. Vetoing powers for Halen.
But I can't do Spirit of the Cunt anymore.
You do Ain't Talking About Cunt?
Wait, hang on. Did somebody vote at Van Halen?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
These two.
This is a bigger... This is the biggest upset in American history. For anything that's ever been voted on. Cool, I'm sure good old Meth Mouth approves.
AC/DC, back in cunt.
I guess me. Golden Earrings versus Journey, Don't Stop, and I'm going to vote for Journey.
Dude, how the fuck did Golden Earring get up in the finals?
Veto powers, bitch.
Yeah, exactly. It's the only way they could.
It's Golden Earring, not Golden Earrings.
I know, that makes it so much They're actually a pretty good super group. They're on a ton of, like, awesome
Golden
super
cunt.
Groups.
Golden Cunt.
Journey.
Should have been Amish Wide Open.
So you veto my Bad Company just to outvote against it in the next. You're a cunt.
That's a better Journey song. That Journey song's better than Golden Earring.
We watched the fucking. I showed John and Brian the Plinkett reviews. Yeah. That shit's fucking great. Whenever he's like, we don't see this loves cunt for the fucking. I lost it.
He needs to do. He doesn't do very much. Like at all, Mr. Plinkett.
Well,
dude, could you imagine trying to do
that? Do you know
that?
Everything that those guys do, though?
Well, yeah, but I'm saying like that character. I would like to see.
I mean,
him.
They do yeah. best he, of the dude, worst.
Did you realize, bag, you realize he lost
a mixed bag.
He lost 40 points of IQ in like 10 years of his life just doing those 3-hour reviews.
I'm sure that could probably be proven the next week.
They made a fucking movie.
Crazy Train.
Yeah, it's like 8
Brad,
hours.
Crazy, Space could God. You Crazy Train for me?
Crazy Train.
Thank you, God. Versus Black Dog. Racist song.
Yeah.
It says black. It has to be.
It couldn't be Chinese Dog.
It's your vote.
Oh.
You're first.
Black Dog.
I'm about to go with Mr. Rhodes, second best guitar player up there, Kirk Hammett.
I don't know anybody in these bands, so.
He's going Crazy Train.
I'm going Black Dog. Train.
Someone's got a veto.
I'll veto Black Dog.
Yeah. Oh man, if it was Immigrant Song, I'd agree with you. No, I wouldn't. Crazy Train's really cool.
Crazy Brad, Train is played on this is played on an electric guitar, David. That's the one
they
that
all
plugs
are.
In.
This is
which one uses the amp?
Carry On My Wayward Son versus Journey. Don't cunt.
Don't cunt.
Don't cunt.
David.
I don't think you'll carry on my cunt word, son.
I'm going
There'll
with carry on.
There'll be peace when you were a cunt. Don't you cunt no more. You have a Minions head. You can't
do
anything
go
but go to your
it's
room.
Fine. This shit has gone off the rails enough. Fucking let someone walk across. Who cares?
She's going to have to break the fucking veto. You know that shit.
Tracy, with that, it doesn't matter. With that Minions head on you, you just need to go to bed. Rest your life.
is it two? Me?
Yeah. Yeah, it's two for Carry On My Wayward Son, one for Journey Don't Cunt.
Two for, or one vote for...
One's timeless.
One for Journey, two
and
for
one's,
Carry On.
I'm going
one, yeah, okay. One's like fucking technically awesome, and one's just a classic that everyone at a bar sings.
Yeah. Yeah, pretty much.
Sang in the showers in basic.
That's weird.
Which one? Hold on. Don't cunt? David.
Yes, sir.
Cunt?
But you gotta whisper it. Just yell it. Be brave.
I
can't do it. I can't even do the joke with one of these.
Why?
Because we get fucking fined. I can't say black cunt.
You can say, why don't you just say,
oh shit!
Why don't you just say cunt dog?
Cunt dog.
Alone in the world, it's a little cunt dog.
No, dude, it made
She's
me
walking
cat.
By
maybe
the
cat.
What in the fuck? All right.
You're never watching the dogs by yourself
again. You guys have all seen
Cat
Dog?
Cat dog.
Yeah. Okay. Alone in the world is a little cunt dog. It works.
That was
just like this
that,
dog is just a little cunt. He's just a fucking cunt. No one wants to be with
that
him.
That was the beginning of the end for Nickelodeon. My opinion.
Ain't Talking About Cunt versus Cunt Dog. And it's to me, actually. Sorry, guys. I'm going with Cunt Dog.
Yeah, I'll do that, too. I'll go with Cunt Dog.
Agree.
Van Halen's great, but that's a better song.
Yeah.
So.
But Zeppelin's amazing.
Okay, here we go. We got Carry On.
Is it Zeppelin 2? One of the best albums of all time.
In the championship.
Yeah,
I'd say it's in the top 20.
Our two contenders are Carry On My Wayward Son versus Black Dog.
All right. That's good.
Tommy, I will allow you to have first vote.
Carry On My Wayward Son.
Carry On My Wayward Son.
Say, you're like the mic of the group where you like to drown it out. I'm going to go with Triumph's Magic Power.
Carry On My Wayward Son.
All right. He's
trying to say you're the mic of the group when Mike is in the group.
Yeah, I know.
He's not a smart gnome.
Mike's not in the group for the next year or so.
His intelligence is
Mike's not here. Mike's not going to be in the group for another 12 to life. 25 to life. Wait, Skid Row. Why didn't we bring
this? I know, that's 18 not that too. 18
in life.
So no matter what you pick, you lose.
I would have picked the Carry On My Wayward Son.
So, according to...
me.
Veto, Black Dog.
Yeah, according to all the vetoes that we used.
According to... That's fine. The two that made it... Well, actually, that's not true. Black Dog did get vetoed in over Crazy Train.
No. Black Dog was a strong pick.
It is.
Crazy Train is like a riff, though. Like, the song
itself. I just want you guys to know that I'm, like, really good at this game.
Are you?
Because you won again.
Well, the two finals were both my songs.
That's true. Yeah.
You win most of them.
Yeah, it's because I'm awesome and I picked great shit.
You planned shit.
No, dude.
I didn't plan any. You know, you have a list.
I put shit. First off, Carry On My Wayward Son beat AC/DC, Back in Black.
Yeah.
Bohemian Rap CD. And Journey.
Rap CD.
Bohemian
Rhapsody. CD.
Listen, I'm fucking
Did
very...
Did that come out in the 90s?
You're calling me a fucking cheater.
I'm surprised
that Fleetwood Mac was picked so easily,
prepare.
To be honest.
I thought you were saying I pair.
You made an actual list. I didn't make a list.
You're saying you just named the most
top 40 songs.
What is this? I just Googled Bohemian Rap CD, and it says Bohemian Rap CD, Little High, Little Low. And it's like...
Chickens.
Oh, bye.
Oh, it's fucking, what's his name from the Muppets?
Oh.
Gonzo fucks those chickens. That's weird.
What the fuck?
You never heard Gonzo that? Fucks chickens.
It's like in the movies. He's like dating one and yeah, he fucks him. But then again, we don't know what the fuck Gonzo is, so we can't call it weird until it's...
He's a weirdo.
He's not human.
He is a weirdo, is what he...
Black Dog
He's an alien. They are weirdos.
Oh, that's a species name?
Yeah.
Black Dog had a much easier route to... It beat Seeger, Crazy Train, and Van Halen. So, Van Halen was probably the only real strong... You guys, it tied Crazy
Train. If you would have done Hunt for a Teacher, would that have won, though?
Ice Cream Man would have won. Sure.
What about Eruption? That has no singing though, but that's fucking incredible. That is technically just a riff.
That is it. Yeah. You can leave, sir. I don't need you here anymore, you fuck.
Smoke.
Enjoy.
So thank you guys. This has been our bracket. Tell us what you think. Tell us if you think that we're fucking assholes and we miss shit. We only pick 16. We don't get to pick everything. Yeah. Can't do it.
Why don't you save smoking for when you hang out with your Tinder or your fucking grinder day tonight, you dickhead?
Oh,
work people.
Well, call them what you want. I just wanted that on the show.
We're meeting at your house
just so these guys can verify before we end this. I literally said, hey, when we do this music bracket, prepare because David's going to be way more fucking obnoxious than normal.
Always. I love music.
It happened.
And it literally was, Brad's like, Bohemian Rhapsody, and David instantly goes,
I love
it.
Like out of the gate. First pick of the night, and instantly David just goes,
eh. Yeah, it went, the train, like, started, it did, like, the, and then it, like, just fell off the rails.
To be fair, though, if this was half an hour without my interruptions, it would have been, like, 10 minutes.
And then people could go back to their lives without fucking...
People might actually watch our shit.
Yeah. That's not true.
They don't want to just hear you bitch, piss, and moan for 10 minutes.
You mean start a conversation?
Hit the buttons, whichever ones you want. We don't really care at this point. Up, down, thumb. You want it...